Ladies and gentlemen, today's guest is arguably the smoothest man on LinkedIn and possibly the entire internet. Garen Bellini from Desk Rig is going to talk to us about how to show up sharp on camera. Well, it's about a whole lot more than that, but stay tuned for a fun-filled conversation with Garen Bellini from Desk Rig.
All right, people. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you happen to be watching and or listening to us. Today on The Corporate Quitters, we have my man, Garen Bellini.
What's going on, Robert? I appreciate you, man. How you doing?
Hey, man, you know what? If I were doing any better, I would be on the beach sipping a pina colada right now.
That does sound great. Up in Canada, it's cold, so anytime you bring in beach, hot weather, and water, ooh, I'm all about that.
Yeah, you guys probably got snowy weather outside right now. It's probably cold just looking outside your window.
Yeah, you know what? We had a bit of a warm front come in, so brought it down to like minus 10 Celsius. So that's like, when it's minus 10, like that's t-shirt and short weather up in Canada, but now we back down. I think, I'm not even joking today, I think we're back down to like minus 50. Like it's cold, so I'm staying in GB3 Studios today. I ain't going outside at all.
And speaking of GB3 Studios, man, why don't you tell everyone, you were just telling me what your life's mission is right now. Tell everybody, what is your life's mission?
I have a lot of life missions, but I'm looking at us right now, and I see like that we got a beautiful banner, says Corporate Quitters. I love your backdrop, Robert. We were talking about this in backstage about just virtual professionalism and making do with what you have, right? I get this a lot for questions, and I've watched your shows, and the fact that you put the pillows on your couch and you line them up all nicely, that's crispy. But I'm looking, and you look great, Robert. Like, you're phenomenal. The backdrop, the lighting, the audio. But I'm looking at me, and it's like, it looks good, but it's not, like, it's not Desk Rig good. Like, what is, oh, hang on a second. We got.
I pull up, like.
There we go. That's a little bit better. There we go. Now we're virtually professional together. There we go. So I'm sorry. I lost track of what your question was. My fault.
You know what? I think you just answered my question, because you also mentioned the word virtual professionalism. Oh, man. I love that term.
It's the easiest way to really break down showing up in video the way you want to. That is my mission. I'm extremely passionate when it comes to video, but not just plugging in a webcam and plugging in a microphone and just ready to go, but really looking at the art of a production and looking at more, like, this is not just the Zoom calls anymore. 2 years ago, when everybody was forced to do this, that was a little bit more acceptable, but we're almost 2.5 years later now, where video has been extremely highlighted, extremely elevated, where, you know, it takes a little bit more and it takes a little bit more effort. So we were talking about, I was up till probably about, I want to say 2 a.m. yesterday, because sometimes in GB3 Studios, you got to do reconfigurations. You know me, Robert. I got a bunch of cameras and everything like that. So cameras here, cameras there. I have to switch them around and set up the stage here. And I know I'll show you a little bit. I can't show the overhead tricks. You got to come to the LinkedIn wish list if you want to see that. But you see me on my virtual background and how we do this. And I got a great chair. I'm sitting in. I'm comfy with you and stuff. But I want to just give me a second. Hang on. I'll be right back.
Uh-oh, wait, people, where is he? Wait a minute, how did he, did you guys see that?
What'd you say? Hey, that's better. Now I'm in the background, chilling and everything like that. We're hanging out with Micro Studio. Virtual professionalism. This is what we do just to be able to elevate the game, to separate yourself from your competitors when you're showing up in video. So this is what we're all about. So I got to, we'll come back to the chair, but I got to come back to the stage. So let's get out of this backdrop here. Hang on.
So look, while Garen is rearranging furniture over there, let's talk to our audience here.
I want to see who's all in the chat. What's going on, everybody? I got this parrot on my channel too, so we going Restream Keeman on him. Thank you, Restream.
Let's take it everywhere. Now, my friend Doreen is here, and she says that's a real studio setup there. Now, Doreen, she's in Canada also, but not quite where you are.
I think she's Eastern Canada, I believe. Toronto. Boom. I know. We got... This is what I get when I tell everybody I'm in Canada. They say, oh, you're from Toronto? I'm like, I mean, there's more places in Canada than just Toronto. But
wait, there's also Ontario.
Ontario. There we go. Well, Toronto's a city, so we got six God the Dot. That's a city. Ontario is the province, so that would be similar to like a state kind of thing. So
now Doreen says, let's go to the beach, man. She's tired of the cold.
Ooh, I'm telling you, people up in Canada during this time, especially January 25th, I used to be getting all that sun in the tan. I'm still like, I got all the white lights coming in. I'm starting to look like a ghost without my tan or anything like that. So I'm with you going to the beach.
Now my friend Shondrea is here, and she's all the way down in Atlanta. Hello, in the U.S.
Hotlanta. I love Atlanta.
You know what? Atlanta wasn't so hot the other day, though. It actually snowed in Atlanta.
Snowed in Atlanta? Did it stay?
Yeah. Now let me tell you, though. When it snows in Atlanta, the whole city shuts down.
Yeah, we're just done.
I wish our city shut down.
We're like minus 50, 7 feet of snow, and we're like, all right, we'll just grab a couple of shovels and head off to school. Like, there's no such thing as a snow day where I'm from, unfortunately.
Now, Garen, Zach says he loves your mission.
Hey, Zach Mofield, what's up, man? Zach's a great individual on LinkedIn. He actually started a podcast. I connected with him last year. He actually went to a conference where they really emphasized the importance of video, and he's an individual who bought in on it. And, you know, he went over and above. He started his own podcast. I believe it's based on like a sports book club. Him and three other individuals, they read a book based on sports. Zach, please put in the comments if I'm butchering your promo of your podcast. But he's an individual that's really going up out of his way to separate himself in this busy world of network marketing and video marketing and all that fun stuff.
Nice. So look, let's talk about virtual professionalism, though. Here, in my opinion, here's why it's so important. In this day of video, oftentimes the first time our customers or potential customers or even people that just want to be our friends, the first time they see us, it's going to be on camera, whether it be recorded content that we put out there or a live podcast like this, or any other means of meeting, even a job interview. Yep. And it is extremely important that we look as professional as we can when we show up, you know, but it doesn't take a whole lot of money. It doesn't take a whole lot of effort, energy, and time. But for you, you spent a lot of time before you were on camera virtually. You spent a lot of time in sales. Ooh. Going door to door.
Door to door, baby. All day long.
What in the
8 years.
What was that like, man?
It was, I love what door-to-door sales have taught me as an individual. You know, there's always the common question, especially, you know, when you're in the United States, is do I go to university or do I go and just figure things out on my own? And we talk about, I feel the dynamic of education is changing in this world, especially you go on LinkedIn. There are phenomenal individuals who are highly knowledgeable, who are excited to help other individuals. LinkedIn Learning is a great platform to be able to, I would go there and do a business 101 course. And on LinkedIn Learning, that's the kind of caliber of that kind of thing. So door to door really taught me the foundations of myself, being able to push myself to the limits. You want to be told, you want to get down, you get told no 70 times in a row. Trust me, I got doors slammed on my face. I got cussed out. I have it all. I had everything you can think of a door selling, but it really developed me into an individual of this, you know, and it goes into your story of being the corporate quitter and just a can-do attitude, not stopping at the basic and just really pushing yourself to the limits. And I am forever grateful for door-to-door, the individuals I met in that industry, because if you can find a high caliber door-to-door sales rep, the sky's the limit for individuals like that.
But here's the question that I have, though. When you were going door-to-door selling, were you dressed so fresh like you do now?
Not this fresh. And the only reason why I wasn't this fresh is because even right now, I look like a slick sales rep. You know what I mean? I look like that the used car salesman. No offense to any used car salesman, because it's a very credible job kind of thing, right? But there's that persona in sales, right, of especially door-to-door. Snake oil type, hey, they're trying to pull the wool over my eyes. It was a really interesting dynamic for myself. So yes, I would always dress professionally. Now door-to-door knocking is a lot less business professional. So professional means a shirt, a collared shirt that's ironed, right? Not wrinkled up and thrown into the corner and then put it on, right? I had the khaki shorts, the shoes, high quality shoes, right? I'm walking everywhere, so I need to have good shoes. So it's just things like that to really make me feel confident. And especially when you're on the door, when you walk in and anything in sales, you feeling fly, you feeling good, you bring that energy out to individuals. And that's anything in sales. That's not just door knocking, but going into door knocking, you have 3 seconds to capture their attention. What's the first thing to do? It's unfortunate, but people judge based off of looks and appearance. And so you be able to put yourself in the best possible position to be successful with that appearance. Comb your hair, brush your beard, brush your teeth. Simple things, right? It's simple, but to some people, you know, there's people who don't brush their teeth twice a day, which is like, dang, come on, right? But you're door-to-door selling and doing that kind of stuff. Those are the things that really separate yourself from these people where it builds that credibility. So now all of a sudden you have 3 seconds like, oh, here's a presentable individual. What has he got to say? Boom, now you get another 3 seconds. And then you go, and then you continually have to ask for their permission for more time. And that's what door-to-door selling. So yes, you have to, no matter what, anything in life, you don't have to be in sales, but just show up, feel confident. Shirt and tie doesn't have to be for everybody. I wear this because I love napping. And you try napping in a suit, it's hard. Put me in my sweats and I'll nap all day. So I wear this to keep myself in check.
but you know, you make a really good point though. You dress for the environment. And even in business environments, even though we're all on Zoom now, people still expect a certain level of virtual professionalism. For example, when I was in corporate environments, I was the bow tie guy. I love bow ties. Ooh. I got tons of them. Yeah. Bow ties, pocket squares, cufflinks. That was me.
You fly. I knew you couldn't fly, Robert. I knew you fly with that.
Yeah, so I almost put on my nice bow tie and my jacket for today. But I said, you know, for me, I'm a little bit more casual. Black is my favorite color. So I really like black. So most of the times you see me in a black shirt. I love black and gray, that combo. I love that. So I have beautiful, a few gray suits colors that I put on. That's really what I like. So, but I want to make sure that I'm looking good on camera. You know, you noticed my pillows, how they were stacked.
Yeah, Dan, you stacked them up nicely. Like the little things. Like little things lead to little things that lead to big things. Those are the kinds of things that separate people from the rest. But it just takes a lot of little things to make that big bang happen.
Exactly. And in the 3 seconds you talked about to getting people's attention. Very true. Like right now, you just said that you were in Canada, but I see a lake behind you and it looks like you're out in a sunny spot somewhere, you know, out on the lake.
Hey, any wherever when with Micro Studio, you can be anywhere in the world. You can be your mom's basement. You can be in the bathroom. You can be anywhere in the world and you look virtually professional. That's what we're trying to produce at Desk Rig and with Micro Studio.
Yeah. So look, you said something to me that was really interesting too though. You said that right now you're set up in a 10x10 space.
Yes. Yes.
I don't believe you.
I get this a lot because you see productions the way I put on like the LinkedIn wishlist. If you're new here, you know, I encourage you every single Friday. We have the LinkedIn wishlist for LinkedIn. It's for content creators just to network, get exposure for active users on LinkedIn. And I get one of two things. I'm in a big studio in an airplane hangar and I have a moderator. And what I need to emphasize is everything you see, all of my content, all of my videos, all of my edits, all of my live shows, everything you see is in-house. I don't outsource any of my content. And I do this specifically to demonstrate the power of Desk Rig. So I love, listen, Robert Bear, because I appreciate what you're doing on LinkedIn and everything. I'm very, very happy to bring you into GB3 Studios. So welcome. Welcome. I got green screens on green screens in here and I set everything up. And I did this specifically for individuals. So you can see here, we have a cloth green screen that comes in the Micro Studio. That comes in a hard shell case for you. So you can set it up anywhere in the world and you can show up with that. I have my pull up green screen here when I do my little fun stuff, but I also, you can't see it just with the angle, but I also have another green screen behind here. So when I do virtual sales presentations, keynote speeches and everything, I have that and it allows me to kind of to walk around. So I got some space to move. I'll grab this thing. You know, I got another microphone here and it allows me, you know, being able to do sales presentations and everything like that. I have guests that come into GB3 Studios so they can come and kick it here. I got a locker room behind the green screen and everything like that. So this is 2.5 years of continual improvement and investing back into myself. All of the money that I've made especially over the last year, I've invested back into myself. I've invested back into this studio and now I can provide all of my viewers, all of my followers and even LinkedIn content creators with an experience that you're not seeing anywhere else. So what do you think, Robert? I appreciate you. Welcome to GB3 Studios, man.
You know what? I am so amazed at what you have captured in such a small space. So, and I'll tell you, one of the reasons this is important to me is because I do training. And so I train accounting and finance professionals. And I would sit on training calls, and I like for people to turn their cameras on so that we can talk and engage.
Yep.
One thing that I figured out early was that you have some junior members in accounting departments who don't make a lot of money, who live in studio apartments, who want to turn their cameras off because they're afraid of showing their dirty bedroom behind. And so I began to talk to their bosses and tell them, your people are afraid to show up on camera, which means they aren't showing up for your clients either. But the reason is not because they're shy or not because they're trying to be difficult in the workplace. They're a little embarrassed. So you need to start with getting them some sort of green screen, helping them learn how to show up visually appealing. So let me ask you a question. What is the first thing that I should invest in if I don't have enough money, and if I don't have enough, if I think I don't have enough money and or space to show up virtually professionally? What's one of the first things that I can invest in?
That's a great question. And I talk about this virtual professionalism. There's three pillars to virtual professionalism that I want everybody to remember. And it doesn't matter about price. It doesn't matter about what products you get. But if you're able to master and understand the three pillars of virtual professionalism, you're winning. And those three pillars are audio, of course. Having good audio doesn't cut out. It allows the viewers, they can close their eyes and they can imagine what Garen Blaney sounds like. They can imagine what Robert Berry sounds like. So that's the first pillar. And remember, hang on. So we got a pillar, right? Tripod. You get rid of one of the tripods, it's going to tip over, right? So you got your audio, you got your visual. So cameras are extremely important. I'm a video guy, so my first recommendation is always going to be invest in high quality video, always. And then the third thing is lighting. Lighting is the most underutilized tool in any Zoom meetings, video meetings, because lighting allows you to create shadows and you can highlight features you're confident with. But you can also low light features you're maybe not so confident with, right? So you can use lighting to your ability. Out of the three pillars, because I'm a video guy, I'm going to tell you to upgrade your video. A lot of the times when you get these high quality webcams, you know what I mean? If you don't, I'm always going to recommend DSLR cameras, mirrorless cameras. I'm always going to recommend that. But listen, if you have to get a webcam, webcams typically come with a little bit of an upgraded mic from your laptop mic. I don't care if you have the newest MacBook or you have a Lenovo ThinkPad or whatever it is, your laptop was not designed to give you good audio and good visual. Your computer was designed to compute. It just happens to have a webcam and a microphone in it now. So to answer your question, it's a long-winded, Robert. I'd highly recommend if you have limited money, invest in a high-quality webcam. If it's a budget thing. However, if it's not a budget thing, or if you have a bigger budget to work with, then there's more we can get in. So hopefully that answers your question.
No, that's perfect, because, you know, webcams, even high quality webcams, aren't that expensive. Even microphones aren't that expensive. And nowadays, I'm finding that even lighting isn't that expensive.
No.
I'm actually traveling right now, and the lighting that I have when I'm back home, I have these, you know, two big lights that I have, and I have the triangular setup, you know, the two and then the one in the back.
There you go. Three-point lighting system. I love that. That's amazing.
There you go. The three-point lighting system. And so now I'm traveling, and you made a comment earlier about my lighting and how it's well lit and everything. And I was showing you, they're just cheap Amazon lights. It's a little tripod and a little cheap Amazon light.
Definitely.
It's an LED light. And I just have them set up quite nicely to hide some of the shadowing and some of the wrinkles on my face.
No, you're right. And I'll even kind of show you. So if you take a look at the Micro Studio, I have a three-point lighting system here. So I have the front camera. So usually when you look at a three-point lighting system, you have a key light, right? You have a key light that highlights the feature you're happy with. You have a fill light. So the fill light's gonna overcast some shadows, but it's also gonna low light the features you're maybe not confident with. And then of course there's a backdrop. So you can even see the green screen. The when I move it, do you see how much of a shadow it casts on this side? You can kind of see that right there. That's all just from one light, right? So it's extremely important, especially when you're using a green screen. this is why people don't like using green screens, is because they think one light works. You know, you have one light that goes on to me and then it works for everything. But then you're finding if you just have one light, you're going to bleed into the green screen. And that's where you, and you can even kind of see it here, because the green screen is extremely hard to master, especially, you know, you can kind of see the kind of the overlays here when you get wrinkles and everything. So very hard to utilize green screens, but we teach us at Desk Rig effective ways to be able to light up your green screen, but also light yourself up. So you're separated from your green screen, opposed to actually getting blended into it. Because you'll see that a lot on Zoom meetings, where they just click the virtual camera or the green screen, and then you'll find that the shoulder is a little bit frayed out and everything like that. So those are the kind of the little tricks that we help teach people at Desk Rig. But this is what we do for the accountants and everything like that. I designed this micro studio specifically for the corporate world, individuals who want to rent this package, sales directors who maybe want their team to be looking uniformed, right? Micro studio is the, you swipe the credit card, you get this in the mail, and then you can show up looking like this kind of thing. So you have the same effect with individuals. So it's really, really fun. But this micro studio, I mean, I don't want to make this a little infomercial. You know me though. You know me, Robert. I'm a sales guy. This is what we do. Come on.
Now look, Charlene is here.
Charlene, what's up? Charlene. Welcome to the Corporate Quitters. I'm not the host this time. I love it. I'm not the host this time.
You know what? At some point, somebody is going to turn the camera on me and interview me on my own show.
I believe
that's going to be scary.
Well, I won't be me. I won't do that to you. Maybe next show. I want to be on. I'll get on Corporate Quitters season two or something. I'll get another episode and I'll interview you. How about that?
Oh, man. Oh, that would be great. And that would be scary as heck for me. But Charlene says she has green screens, but not sure how to properly position the lights yet.
Okay, no worries, Charlie. I can work with you. And I even know it's a lot of people, there's more than just a green screen, right? There's a blue screen too. Does anybody know that there's actually a blue screen? It doesn't necessarily have to be green, right? So I've seen that a few times. So don't, but yeah, position with a camera, Charlie, and happy to help you out with some, just let me know if it's shadows you're having issues with or whatever it is. More than happy to kind of walk you through that. Cause it can be easily mastered, but it takes effort, right? Sometimes you just have to fluff up the pillows behind you to make it look beautiful, right?
Man. Yeah, it is all about learning some different tips and tricks. Because like you just said, the three pillars of virtual professionalism, audio, visual, and lighting. But I think it's important to show up as professional as you can, because it helps build what everybody talks about, the know, like, and trust factor. This is if you're an entrepreneur, a solopreneur, or someone on a job interview, or an employee engaging with fellow employees at your organization. So your first recommendation is to not use the camera that's on my laptop. And if money is an issue, start with a high quality webcam, but you really think we should get a DSLR camera, because those are a lot better than the webcams.
Yes. And I say this, not cautiously, but I did it the expensive way. I did it where I bought the $70 webcam. Like, y'all want to see something right now? I'll take y'all. Y'all want to go to OGTV? Hang on a second here. Let me line this up for you. I'll take y'all to OGTV. This is my very first webcam. Let me see if I can line up the camera, the sunglasses on this one. This is the hater blockers, right? These are the people who don't like videos. So, but this is the camera right here that I first invested in. So it was a Costco camera, AverMedia, it's a good quality camera, like a very good picture, but this is what I started with, and I started getting more sales, shortening my sales cycle. I'm like, oh man, like there's something here. And then I started to casually upgrade and buy all of the equipment and everything. So if people and individuals are wanting to really invest in this, but if money is a thing, I'll respect that. But what I want to recommend is if it's a budget's concern, save delayed gratification, okay? Because you go and spend $300 on a webcam, Canadian, right? I don't know what the American currency is, so probably like $2 or something like that. But I'm in Canada, like, you know, $300, right? And then all of a sudden you love what the picture is and you're like, oh, what's next? What, you know? But then I get this a lot is, Garen, I have a webcam, I have a microphone. Like, why don't I look like you? Well, because it's a little bit more dynamic than that, right? But it's I kind of tread lightly with giving recommendations like that, because I do respect people's budgets. But if you really want to do it right, if doing it gradually steps up, actually ends up being more money in the long run. However, you know, gradually investing in yourself is not a terrible idea either. You just need to be okay with knowing at the end goal, you're going to be spending more money than you did if you just paid everything for upfront kind of thing.
Now, Claire has a question for you. She says, Claire, how about Claire, a roll of paper or vinyl?
What was the question? Sorry, vinyl or paper?
Yeah, she said, how about a roll of paper or vinyl lighting shining on them behind you?
Yes. That could work. That actually could. I do, you know, you get the 3D background of the vinyl and everything like that. Sometimes glare can be an issue, though, too. So if you're going to do a vinyl print or something like that, I'd recommend maybe getting a matte finish, not a glossy finish, because you get that, then you're going to cause reflections and everything like that. And we talk about that at Desk Rig, too, is even with your backdrop, you know, stay away from mirrors. Stay away from even, I get this a lot. You have your picture of your family and they look beautiful and everybody's happy, but then the reflection of the camera, the picture, I can see what you're doing on your screen. And I know you're not paying attention to me. You're on Facebook, on LinkedIn, chatting or something like that, right? So those are the kind of things to be mindful of with the backdrop, right?
Yeah. You know what? I tell you another trick that I found on a budget, I actually got poster boards from the Dollar Tree that were green.
Listen, green screens, I went $2 green screens and I put them on my desk. So when I do product demonstrations, I have a green screen on my desk. Listen, I love to ball, but I love to ball out more on a budget. I'm telling you, balling out on a budget is the way to do it. Come on. So yes, dollar store, green screen. Yes, I love it. It's just hard to do. I wouldn't recommend grabbing like 20 of those things and taping them together. Like, if you want it for your desk, it's a great opportunity to do like a product demonstration where, you know, you're going to do this and you have a green screen underneath and then you can hit the bell and all that kind of fun stuff. So those are kind of cool things to do with a phenomenal idea. Great work.
I tell you what, I have admittedly, I have done the whole taping them together. Just four.
And how did it work?
It worked in the short run. Yeah.
Short run, but it worked. So, and there's nothing wrong with that, Rob. That's what virtual professionalism, man. You went out of your way. You saw that, hey, I want to improve. I want to be better. What's the best way I can do it with what I have right now? Rather than just sitting, and this is what I talk about. It's a lot of people like to complain about different things and everything and what's not right in their life and this and that, but they don't provide a solution. So and this is why I left the corporate world. I'm sitting there, Zoom fatigue. Anybody remember that? We don't like Zoom calls because of how they're so bad. So this is why I left the corporate world, because I'm like, there's no reason why Zoom calls and virtual meetings are still this bad. So I'm complaining, but I provided a solution for individuals, right? So you, rather than sitting there and saying, oh, well, I guess I don't have all the money in the world, so I guess I'm just going to, you went out, provide yourself a solution. Hey, you found out it was a short run solution, but a solution nonetheless. So thank you for doing that. That's virtual professionalism right there.
Yeah. Like I said, I think that's what it's all about. And Chris is laughing at us.
What's up, Chris? Chris Stone knows all about it.
Chris Stone says, balling on a budget.
Listen, yeah, he's a great individual to listen to and to watch. He has a great studio, a little setup. I know he does remote production. Dealcasters, I believe, is his company name. Please put it in the chat, Chris, because I'm promoting people. I'm probably promoting the wrong thing for them. I'm like, this and that, no problem. But listen, he's a great individual to watch, follow. If you're looking for high-quality content creators on LinkedIn, Chris Stone's a guy to follow.
Awesome. Yeah, Chris, drop it in the chat because, look, everyone who's chatting, connect with one another.
Oh, yeah.
You never know who might, you know, benefit you or who you might benefit in the future. But here's the question I have for you now, Gary.
Oh, yeah.
PC or Mac?
Oh, both. Listen, great question. I get this a lot. I love that. I love Apple. I love MacBooks. I'm an Apple dude. This was a big debate for myself when investing in my desk rig. My older brother, he's a gamer guy. He knows all the, you know, the graphics cards and all this fun stuff. I'm like, yo, listen, I'm an Apple dude. I want to get in. The thing that people need to be mindful when getting an Apple product is we all know how Apple likes to just create their own thing. Remember, they got rid of the headphone jack just because they're like, get rid of that. We don't need that. Like the rest of the world has headphone jacks, right? So it's those things that kind of happen with Apple. It's very exclusive to Apple products. Now, Apple products, like their webcam and their laptop microphone, are phenomenal. If you want to put into a comparison of if you can only get a laptop camera and microphone, Apple probably has a leading edge on that. I do both now. So I highly recommend, if you're getting a desk rig, get a PC. PCs are just way more open. They're more just, you can get a lot more stuff to have it communicate with the package. This is the thing, ladies and gentlemen, when you start getting into production like this, it's not just plugging in a couple things and having them work, right? They have to communicate with each other. They have to integrate with each other, right? And it's technology, people. It doesn't always communicate the way it's supposed to do. So both are very phenomenal options. However, both are different paths and have different strategies in order to get the same result. We do have training on Apple. We do prefer PC. However, I'm investing in another MacBook just so I can teach myself Ecamm Live, different things, because listen, I'm the leader in this space, so I need to teach myself and keep myself ahead of the curve so I can come back to shows like this, Corporate Quitters, and I can answer questions and not just be pulling it out of my rear. I don't know if we can swear on Corporate Quitters. I don't know.
You know what I appreciate, though? I really appreciate the way you gave the politically correct answer.
Oh, come on. Yeah.
I get that. But over here where I am, I don't engage in the forbidden fruit. And that's... that's why I brought up my friend Charlene's comment. She said she needs to upgrade her DSLR since her MacBook decided to switch up. That's what happens when you take a bite of the forbidden fruit, Charlene. See,
wait, tell me more. What is this forbidden fruit? What is this? Come on.
Apple. I'm not an Apple guy.
Oh, the Apple. You're okay. The
forbidden fruit, man.
Okay, well, then I answered that quite good, because if I would have gave the answer that I really felt, I probably would have got kicked off the show with that. So thanks.
Now, I like the way you answered it, because, I mean, you have to know both products, because you are doing stuff in the virtual space, and so it's important for you to know both products so that you can help your clients to navigate either product.
Yep, and you look at the demographic of what we're doing at DeskRig. You know, there's a high percentage are Apple users, and my job is not to go to them and be like, hey, shame on you for eating the forbidden fruit. Come over to PC. That's not my job. That's somebody else's job, right? My job is to say, hey, what do you have? You got to go talk to Robert Berry on that one. But my job is to really look at and this is what really my expertise comes in, because I don't only just set up workstations. I actually customize home studios. So I've done custom studios, because north-facing windows, south-facing windows, where your desk is, how big your room is, these all play critical roles when placing your desk rig into your house. And I just over the weekend, I did a configuration for a client in Saskatoon here, and Apple user, right? So it actually allowed me to work more on the Apple products, and it works phenomenal, but it's just a different process with that. But it goes further than just the actual hardware. Creating an environment of your work from home space is what I'm really passionate about. I've worked from home for the last 6 years, and I've worked from the kitchen table. I've had to wake up in the morning, and I'm an outside sales executive. So what do I do in the mornings? I cold call all day long. I have business cards. I have notepads. I have my laptop. And I had to put that all on the kitchen table. And at the end of the day, I had to pick it up, because there was no way at that time, there was no way I could just leave all my stuff on the kitchen table. I get yelled at, right? So I had to pick that up. So now I'm fortunate enough to be able to have a designated workspace where I've customized it strategically. You know, it's not just looks on it, strategically placed the shelving and the lighting where we did. But it allows individuals, work from home, remote workers, we create an environment that empowers individuals and makes you excited to go to work, because this, you love the space that you're working in. What else we got in the chat? I'm throwing a lot at you, Robert. Yeah. Have you figured out how I like to talk yet? I'm a mic hog. Everybody's dropping mics on these shows on LinkedIn. I'm on the ground picking up all the mics. I'm like, why the hell is everybody dropping all these mics? Damn.
You know what? We have a LinkedIn user that says, yes, positioning of your office equipment is also very important. Great point. And Farah has also just joined us.
Good morning, Farah. And, welcome.
So good morning, Farah. So Farah, listen, since you just joined us on episode number 33 of the Corporate Quitters podcast with 33. Garrett Bellini. 33, that's right. 33.
Bam. There we go.
Look here. We're talking about the three pillars of virtual professionalism. We talked a little bit about visual. So Garen recommends that, look, don't use the camera that's on your laptop. Upgrade. We talked a little bit about
everybody should upgrade, no matter where you're at. I still upgrade, ladies and gentlemen. And there should be no reason why I'm sitting here upgrading, but I still upgrade, because that's the importance of just anything in life. Self-investment. Invest back into yourself in order for you to perform more efficiently, more strategically, so you can start making more money.
Yeah, and I think it is very, very important though to really get the visuals right, get the audio right, and get the lighting right. And like you just said, you worked from your kitchen for a short period of time.
It was two and a half years. That's a short while, man. I guess. It is, but that's what you have to do, right? Make do with what we have. And you know, do it. And then delayed gratification.
Yeah. Well, and it's all about knowing your space, because I'll tell you something. So, you know, I just showed you guys one of the lights that I'm using here, and I said I have three. But you have to know your space. So, for example, I'm sitting up right now in an extremely uncomfortable position, because when I lean back, you can see the shadows over there.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't like the shadows. Virtual professionalism. You don't have to have a lot of money to do it. But what you do have to do is make sure these three pillars that Garen has talked about, audio, visual, and lighting, are fairly decent.
Yes.
And then know your environment.
Your positioning of your camera is extremely important, right? How many times do we do, I'll switch cameras, but how often do we go into virtual meetings where it doesn't look, right? When you're going to virtual meeting, look at yourself. You're centered in the frame. There's not too much gap up top. You know, I can't see your belt line or anything like that, right? It's very, very respectable and you're within your frame. How often do we go into virtual meetings where it's skied down like this, right? So it creates kind of a persona that you're looking down on me, right? Or you're too zoomed in, or you're too far up or down, right? This happens a lot where you're not doing proper framing with the camera itself. So another extremely important tip with virtual professionalism, know your lens, know your angles, so you can center yourself in the frame. Even right now, look at myself, my head's cut off. So I look at this, I'm like, oh man, I'm too close to the camera. Maybe I should sit back and lean down a little bit, right? Maybe I should tilt up my camera a bit. Do that. Make a slight adjustment. Hey, that's a little bit better. That looks a little bit better now, right? So those are the kind of things we changed. But you can see here, it's not as good as I thought because we got the green screen there. So anyways, we'll put that back down. You know what I mean? So minor tweaks to be virtual professional.
Yeah. And knowing your environment is extremely important. You mentioned you can't see my belt line. That's good because I have on pajama bottoms.
Hey, that's what we do in the virtual. You want to see what I got on down here? I ain't wearing no clothes under the belt. That's why we just keep it up there. No problem, man.
Hey, man, LinkedIn is a PG family-friendly environment.
And you don't get banned on LinkedIn, man. Anything goes on LinkedIn. I go on YouTube and I go on Facebook. I get banned all the time, man. LinkedIn don't care. They're like, GB, you go do you. So I love LinkedIn for that.
I know that's right. And Shree has entered the room and she says, hey, welcome, Robert Shree. Barry and Garen Bellini.
Hello. Good morning, everyone. What time is it there for you? About 2 hours ahead, right?
Oh, man, I'm only one. It's 7:40 for me. It's 8:40 over in New York for people on the East Coast. And people on the West Coast, they're still sleeping. Either that or they just come in from a long night out and still in a drunken stupor. One of the two.
On a Tuesday? Or no, what day is today? Sometimes I lose track of what day. Is it Monday? I don't even know what day is today. Tuesday.
It is Tuesday, right? Yeah.
This is how much I love my job. It's just like I just work for Friday because I love the LinkedIn wish list. I love doing lives like this. I mean, you know, I try to do this stuff every day because I get energized with it. And I love educating people. You know, I left the corporate world. My original goal was to be a virtual sales trainer and help individuals, younger professionals, understand the importance of being able to pick up the phone, have a conversation, right? I fear a younger generation is not going to be able to pick up the phone and call a stranger and have a conversation with them. I hope it doesn't happen, but that was my original passion with that. So I love being able to come onto shows like this. So thank you, Robert, for having me. This is really, really fun. I love this.
All right. So talk to everyone about the wish list. That is
LinkedIn
your
wish
show.
List. Listen,
what is it about?
Gentlemen. Oh, come on. It's the LinkedIn wish list. It's your show. I am just the host. The LinkedIn wish list. It's just a place for content creators, like-minded individuals to come, network, enjoy a show. I combine education with entertainment. I'm confident to say it's probably a show that nobody's really seen before, especially when I tell them it's just me doing all the controls, all of the camera switches, all the overlays. Everything is in-house, so it's a really unique situation. But I really try on the LinkedIn wish list to bring the audience into it. So you come to the LinkedIn wish list, you put your wish in the chat. What are your desires? What do you wish for? What do you want to achieve in 2022? Put in a LinkedIn wish list, but you have to hashtag wish list to double your odds. So if you want to double your odds of your wish coming true, put it in the chat. So it's every Friday. Listen, I try to, my timings are still off on my Fridays. I just try to find an open slot that doesn't collide with anybody else that are doing live shows, because I find Fridays are very, very active with live streamers in that community. So I really want to respect individual's time slots. So I my timings are off. I'm usually doing about 4 o'clock right now, but I think Club Link usually has that time slot. So for right now, this week, it's going to be doors open 3:50 Central Standard Time. We do the desk rig dance cam, which is kind of fun. So I'll show you last week we went, this is kind of the desk rig dance cam, but then I also have on the side of the corner there, we got a few of the fun stuff. So I got me that came in the one time too. So we got this, we got another GB3 in here. How many Garen Blaney's do you want? So this is the desk rig dance cam. We come and we have some fun, gives you an opportunity to network and everything like that. So that's my live show for right now.
And I encourage everyone to tune in, especially if you're creating content, because you learn something every single week. Also, hashtag wishlist. Garen will pick that up and answer some of your questions. And speaking of questions,
thank you.
Jim says, how are you streaming this? OBS? Restream? How are you doing this?
I can't give away those secrets. Come on, Robert. I'm just kidding. Listen, I love Restream, and I love StreamYard, and I love these simplified streaming platforms. These platforms are amazing for individuals who maybe fear technology a little bit. They don't have the proper equipment. Restream and StreamYard and even Melon and all of these other platforms, they're really simplifying the process for the beginner streamer. Now, saying that, I use OBS all day long. And the reason why I do that is because I did this on purpose, even just going into virtual meetings. Because when I was in the corporate world, I had WebEx, I had Zoom, I had Google Hangouts, I had Microsoft Teams. And what I found during those early times is Microsoft Teams had a different way to share a screen. Google Hangouts has a special way to be able to invite guests. And right, so they're all the same platform, but because they always want to be different, they have different features that suit them. So my brain, like, this is only 32 gigs up in this bad boy, right? So I got to limit as much space as I can, right? So why do I want to teach myself all of these different platforms? And now we got StreamYard, we got Vidyard, we got all these streams, and it's going to get more and more. Like, it's not, there's going to be a new Restream, there's going to be a new StreamYard that comes out, and now we have to reprogram the way we think. No, OBS allows us to, it's your control center. I like to think of Restream, StreamYard, all of these places. These are airports in the virtual world. You roll up on the Restream airport, dang, tarmac's nice, automatic open doors, but you go to a different streaming platform, and maybe you have to push the doors, and the tarmac's a little bit bumpy. So they're all different platforms. However, if you use OBS and you understand the capabilities of OBS, it allows you, I can pull up to anything. I click virtual camera, I can be on any platform, and I know my controls. I know, right? You know, I'll move this down onto my screen, and then with a simple button, I can switch, share the screen. This is OBS that I work with on a constant time, so I have studio mode and everything like that. So I know everyone's like, oh, you just go to YouTube University and you learn OBS. No, OBS is way more dynamic than just, and I learned a lot on YouTube, but just because you learn on YouTube doesn't mean the timing. Like, people, oh, you learn on YouTube University. It's like, just because you learn on YouTube University doesn't mean the time to learn it is anything less. It's just YouTube. You can just binge watch hours and hours of information. Whereas when you go to university, you know, I'd have a business 101 class, and it would be 1 hour sessions 3 times a week. And it took me 6 months to complete that course. Not in the virtual world anymore. You can really accelerate your information, but time. Not a lot of people have that time, right? I took that time. I learned myself. Let me teach you now. Don't waste your time on YouTube trying to figure it out. Come to Desk Rig. We'll simplify it for you, and you can roll up looking like GB3 all day long.
So let's talk about this for a minute, because a lot of people don't know what OBS is. OBS stands for Other Broadcasting Software.
Yeah, Open Broadcasting Software.
Open Broadcasting, sorry, yeah. And it is free, 100% free.
But free 99,
the thing
baby.
That's great about it is on par with what professional television studio broadcasters use. As a matter of fact, some of them actually use OBS. Yes. You can download it for free, and a lot of people are intimidated by it because there is a learning curve. But once you get past that learning curve, the world is open up to you. All the nice tricks and tips that Garen does, OBS allows you to do them easily. I actually know how to use OBS, and at some point, I'm going to switch to start using it because it allows multiple cameras and just all kinds of features that are just amazing. now.
And you can program it to have, like, you switch a camera with a button. You go, yep. Right? Switch it back kind of thing, right? All with the buttons. So now, and I don't have to look down. I can still maintain conversation. I can still do all of these fun things. So this is what DeskRec teaches. If you want to learn OBS, we have an OBS course for individuals. If you want a customized OBS for your specific desk rig, we'll customize a specific one for you. And this in remote productions, all you remote producers out there, you want to work with DeskRec? You want to make some money being a remote producer? You need to understand OBS. You need to, yep. Or else we can't bring you into DeskRec, because this is what we use as a foundation for our virtual professional trainings. And we do international events, right? A couple months ago, we did an international event in Italy for the Agrobiodiversity Congress. There was about 5,000 people on the live, but we need remote production. We need individuals who want to dive into this. But you need to learn these programs. It's just like minimum credentials when you go to university. All those kind of fun stuff, right? So, all right, Robert Berry's gone, so I can do the show. So this is the green screen, everyone. We do the pull-up. So Garen Parkins has a GP pull-down. He does this all the time. And I got mad at Garen Parkins. If you had, like me, you got to follow Garen Parkins. But he had a pull-down maneuver. I said, Garen Parkins, you got a dope-ass signature, man. Like, what's my signature move? And I made my signature the pull-up. So that's how we do it. Every time we pull the green screen up, we do that one.
I pull up. Like.
That's how you pull up. That's how you pull up in the virtual world.
Now, Garen.
Yeah.
Doreen is saying she feels like she's taking a live stream 101 course. Now, Doreen, if you think this is a course, you probably need to call Garen. Get on the phone with him. He will blow your mind. But Claire wants to know, where in the world you get that fur coat from?
Ooh, the fur coat? I actually hunted a mink myself, bare hands, and humanely put down. No, it's funny. What was it before the bay? Eaton's. I don't know if that's down in the States, up in Canada. There was the warehouse store. It's called the Bay now, but it was Eaton's. It was actually my auntie's, and she's been in the closet for a long time. And I was at my dad's house a couple months ago. Yeah, it's a nice fur coat. Like, whose is this? How come no one's using this? And I was like, I don't know. So I took it as a prop, I guess. So now that's the LinkedIn wish list. So I even have that. You want to see the LinkedIn wish list commercial? We can do that. You want to see a little overlay on that one?
Hey, man, go for it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are on the Corporate Quitters. My name is Garen Blaney. We're with Robert Berry, and I'm the host of the LinkedIn wish list. Let's get down with the day down. Come on.
Hey, this is radio station WSKEE. We're taking calls on the wish line, making your wacky wishes come true.
Hello. Back. Can you see me? Can you hear me? Hold up. Hey, God. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Can't see me.
Can't see.
No problem.
You're an incredible invisible man right now.
Oh yeah. No problem. See, I'm out here trying to flex like that, and I can't even.
Here's what I want everyone to realize, though. Earlier in the show, Garen showed us his space. He's in a space that's about 10x10. He has 3 green screens up. And he's able to switch between various scenes, and he's able to do a bunch of different navigating around the scene from a small space.
This is true. I'm doing troubleshooting right now. So this is also the power of DeskRec, because sometimes technology goes out. Boom, there I am. Hello.
Listen,
Robert, I do this all myself. So like the camera goes out. What do? This is what DeskRec teaches, because we're doing a live stream right now. How stressful is that if a camera goes out? How many, you know what I mean? How do we problem solve? Listen, the virtual sales checklist. This is what we do. Hey, when camera goes out, do this, A, B, and C, and D. Boom. Now we back. Right? So I apologize for that. I wanted that to be a lot smoother than it was. I get too confident. You got to chill me out a little bit there, Robert. I'm getting too confident with this stuff, and I'm making myself look like a fool. Come on, man.
but you know what? It actually goes back to what you were saying, though. 3 pillars of virtual professionalism: audio, video, lighting.
Lighting.
Now, there's a slight echo that we have now.
Yeah.
But it's like Doreen was saying, when I disappeared, my light went out.
Yeah, what happened? I hit my intro button. I thought it was the intro button, and then what ended up happening is I ended up opening up my LinkedIn webpage, and then so it popped up. So I was staring at you, the teleprompter, and then it went away. I'm like, oh God, what's happening? So then you disappeared too, or what happened with you? Were you just sitting there having a good time?
Well, I actually got up to change my light.
Okay. Oh, that's
now
why
there is a real bad echo.
I would listen. See, that's another thing. Confirm power and battery. I do this a lot too. Like I have these batteries and stuff like that. Every time I go into a virtual meeting and a presentation, make sure your batteries are charged. There's so many times where I went to a meeting and there's nothing worse than like a random light going out because you forgot to charge your battery. So that's extremely important. But before going into a live show or any sort of stream, bow, virtual sales checklist, baby. Well, I'm having fun. Right now you mute. Now you're back.
Now I think we need to go through the virtual sales checklist because I still hear.
You hear an echo?
Echo.
All right. Hang on. Okay, so we got Doreen. Check your mic. We can barely understand you. Audio visual. Let me check. I got cable A here. Switch there.
Let me check mine as well.
Could do cable C. You know what it probably is? There we go. How's the echo now?
Echo gone.
That was me. My bad, yo.
Well, and you know, but these are the things that we have to learn, especially if we are doing virtual productions on our own. Because you're a one-man shop. I'm a one-man crew. Again, my light went out, so I had to step away for a minute, and that's why Doreen was laughing. She was like, Rob, you just disappeared. Yeah, now my light's back on, thankfully, but who knows what else is going to happen.
Hey, anything's possible in the corporate quitters, man. No problem.
But, again, our three pillars, audio, visual, lighting. If you really want to learn more about them, Garen is your man.
I'm happy to help anybody who wants to become a better live streamer, who wants to learn more about the ins and outs with it. I love this stuff. And sometimes I kind of like when things screw up, right? It keeps me in tune, right? You know, if you just show up and this is the thing, ladies and gentlemen, technology, you can look what I have. Everybody saw what I have, and technology still has an opportunity to hiccup, right? So technology works, but it's the user that needs to be able to work the technology, because a mic's going to mic, a light's going to light, right? You know, a computer's going to compute. So you need to understand the tools that you have. So if your knife's a little bit dull, you got to be able to sharpen it up quickly for you. So I kind of like that it is screwed up a little bit, because it just humanizes people, because you can have all the things in the world and you can still trip up a little bit, and that's okay.
I tell you what, so I was on one of my shows one time, and I was just talking, and I was muted for about 90 seconds. Didn't even know it. Don't know what was wrong, and then people were in the chat, we can't hear you, and I'm thinking, I'm speaking loud, so what did I do? I started talking louder.
Hey, what else do you do if they say they can't hear you? You just start screaming, of course. And this is why a live audience is so important. Listen, and you're coming into the chat, people are like, oh no, we can't hear him. Maybe nobody, you need to tell us, because I want to know. Like, there's been so many times on LinkedIn wishlist, I went on a rant. I'm spitting gold. Whoever would have heard that would have had the keys to $1 million, but I was on the dang mute button. So I'm always trying to be mindful of that. So when I'm spitting all the knowledge that everybody can learn, and I'm not stuck with the dang mute button. And I also have a mute button jar in here. Every time I get caught on mute, I put some money in the jar, because shame on me for not knowing the mute button. I mean, it's just like shooting free throws. Hit your free throws. That's a free throw in live streaming. Hit the damn mute button off. Come on, man.
So here's a question, though. For someone who does mess up, like we just did a few times, what would you recommend they do to recover?
Stay calm. Like, right immediately you just start panicking. There's going live is intense as it is. It's very scary, and I understand why a lot of people avoid live, because I mean, we're in a world of like cancel culture, and you say one thing and they don't know who you are and you're done. So I'm waiting for my time till that happens. Who knows? Hopefully not. Hopefully I get a little bit of traction. Hopefully I'm like a millionaire by that time and I can just like wave off into the wind. But it's just stay calm. Right. And a lot of the times you'll find is people don't really notice. I watch game film every time I do my LinkedIn wishlist. I'll watch game film and I'll watch for, hey, was my stream stuttering? Was it kind of glitchy? You know, where did I screw up? I watch that stuff and pay attention to it. But if you go into technical difficulties, you know, stay calm, go to the chat. Hey, just screwing up or something like that. What I actually have, and it's kind of funny, anytime I have technical difficulties, I should have done this, but I'm usually really quick with it. But I do. Oh, hey. You give yourself an overlay that says technical difficulties, please hold. And you just put that overlay on and gives you an opportunity to go in behind the scenes and try to figure everything out that you're trying to figure out.
I love it. That's a great tip. I had actually seen that on some template websites that help you design different things for your shows, and I never thought about that. And then the music,
you know what I'll
too,
do, Robert? Just for you and the corporate quitters, I'll create a custom corporate quitters technical difficulty overlay that you can give to all your viewers. It'll be a free overlay. I'll create that for you all and everybody on here. So thank you so much for understanding when we, as live streamers, get to technical difficulties. We're working on it. So I'll write that down. I'll make sure I get a custom overlay for you so you have something like that if anything does happen.
Awesome. Now, Doreen says she's going to work on that. She likes that.
Listen, anybody who says I'm going to work on it or I'm going to improve on whatever they're doing in life, good. I appreciate that. Just keep getting better at whatever you're doing. Just please, right? And you'll feel more fulfilled and everything else will take care of itself after.
So, all right, you guys. Corporate Quitters, episode number 33. Garen Bellini from DeskRig.
Dang. Look, I appreciate you, man. This is super fun.
Three pillars of virtual professionalism. Your audio, your visual, your lighting. If you really want to talk about those things, though, this is the man right here because he'll have you flying in and out of your screen and
Zipping, zopping, hipping and hopping, whatever you want. Live streamings, DeskRig, we got you every step of the way. And DeskRig is an investment. It's not a purchase. This is not a hey. All right, I say this. I'm a slick sales rep, but I ain't that slick, right? If I give you all this equipment, I'm not just gonna let you run with it. I want to make sure that you're comfortable with it and you're performing your best self because you're representing DeskRig. So DeskRig is a truly an investment in yourself, and it's like what everybody likes to say on LinkedIn. I don't like saying it, but it's a community. It's an environment that you can come and everybody can come be better. So anybody who has desire to get better in video, live streaming, we got you at DeskRig. No problem.
All right, so now, how can we get in contact with you guys over at DeskRig?
There's a few ways. I'm very active on LinkedIn, so everybody who's watching here, if you send me a LinkedIn message, that's going to get to me a lot quicker than, say, an email, anything like that. You can go to www.deskrig.com. You can also go to microstudio.design. And another fun fact, if whoever's watching on their desktop right now, I'll ask you to go, you can go to... Nope. I'll go to this one. Let me see. Let's go to open house here. This QR code. All right, hang on. We got to get GB3 out of the way. That guy, hang on. There's too many Garens on the screen. Hold up. Get out of the way. Scan this QR code. Ladies and gentlemen, this is going to get you prompted to microstudio.design. All this information will come to DeskRig. We'll be able to reach out to you. So if you do have desire and want to learn more, scan the QR code and we will get you to where you need to be. Boom. That's my little promo for that.
And again, if you guys saw the small space that he's operating in,
very
I think
small.
That's
micro
awesome.
Studio. Micro studio. Yeah. Listen, you don't have, and I do custom studios for, I've done a lot of high caliber clientele where I've been able to go to their house, understand what they're looking for, and customize something really, truly special. And you give me a spare bedroom, and I will allow you to create Hollywood cinematics for the comfort of your home.
Yeah, and I think, like I said, I think it's very important that we show up virtually professional with our clients, with our coworkers, because we want to make sure that we maintain a certain air of professionalism. That doesn't mean breaking the bank. If you saw what I had set up here, you'd say, oh, that's it? Wow. It's not breaking the bank.
You look great, Robert. Don't even worry about that kind of thing. People don't need to see what's behind the scenes. They just need to see what's on the screen, right? So don't ever feel bad that you're trying, all right? You're doing great things, Robert. I appreciate what you're doing for LinkedIn, video, and everybody on this. It's phenomenal to see individuals like you do this stuff on a consistent basis and still want to learn to get better.
Oh, man, I appreciate that. I'm just trying to, you know, help out, spread whatever messages I can.
We're all doing.
yeah, we're all in this together. All right, so any last words you have for our folks before we sign off for the day?
Listen, I appreciate y'all again. I'm here. You have any questions? You know where I'm at. I'm always on LinkedIn. Come check out the LinkedIn wishlist every single Friday. It's a fun place. And the great part about it is your show. I'm just the host on that one. So I'd like to have some fun. Come enjoy it. And it'll be, let's just push the limits and let's continue to prove every day, ladies and gentlemen.
I like that. It's our show. He is just the host. The LinkedIn wishlist on Fridays. Like and on that note, my friends, we're out.
We're out.
Thank you for listening to the Corporate Quitters Podcast. If you like us, tell everybody you know. Better yet, head on over to the iTunes store and leave us a 5-star review. It only takes a few seconds,
I can do it with my eyes closed and both hands tied behind my back, so what are you waiting for? If you want to talk to us, leave us a voice message. You might be featured on the show. Check the link in the show notes. Want to carry us wherever you go? Check out the merch on our website. Get your I Quit, O Quit, or just plain quit stuff there. If you really, really like us, you can become a monthly contributor for less than a cup of coffee. Link is in the show notes. And last but not least, quit those limiting beliefs that are holding you back. And we're out.